Let's try this for a new camera angle. So, it is the August 10K writing challenge. I don't know how many of these I've done so far, but this is actually my second 10K day of August. I did one during the Wander Writers Retreat and actually hit 10K around like 1:30 a.m. So if I get another 10K today, I will be very impressed with myself because that's a lot of words in 1 month. I actually have a plan to either finish the manuscript this month or finish it halfway through September. And currently my manuscript sits at 35,831 words, which means I'm almost at the halfway point of my manuscript. And when I realized that, I realized, wow, I have a lot of work to do. Now, I do think I am underwriting at this point. I know for a fact there are scenes that I literally just wrote dialogue and nothing else, just because it was flowing like that. And while that's awesome, I like to add in descriptive stuff. I like to add in imagery. So there's a lot of imagery missing from this manuscript at this point. So I think I'm actually, I know for a fact, if I look at my outline, that I'm more than halfway through the story right now. So, I'm nervous, and Phil's walking by. So like I was saying, if I do another 10K today, that would be my second 10K for the month. However, I have a lot of writing to do. I have a lot of rewriting. If you are a patron over on Patreon, you know I already have a like tentative release date for this fourth novel I'm working on. And it's a very intense deadline that I've given myself. But I've also given myself this deadline keeping in mind with other things I have in mind for the future. So this book will be like hopefully with beta or alpha readers when I am like doing some busy stuff during my lifetime. Oh my goodness, stop walking, you keep distracting me. Today, to make things a little more... Today, to make things a little more interesting, because I'm already 3,000 words in, very happy about that, but to make things, to make the words flow a little bit better, I'm gonna try the Comic Sans trick, where you put your font to Comic Sans, and I guess it looks so ugly that you have no desire to reread your work or edit your work. That's never really been an issue for me, but I guess I'll try it out and see if it helps me a little bit. I don't know. I feel like it's gonna be distracting to me and it's gonna annoy me, but I'll let you know how it goes. Okay, so Comic Sans, not a fan of it. I have decided that. I used it for only 2 sprints, I think, but they were my 2 worst sprints. I got 955 and then 701. Now it could just be because I'm starting to feel a little burnt out, and I've also reached another point in my outline where things aren't totally fleshed out, so that could be it. But I've also just found the Comic Sans font to be very distracting. I think I would have done better with just my regular font. And yeah, so me, not a fan of Comic Sans. I think I do better without it, so I call this a fail. However, the 10K challenge shall go on. I'm gonna go back to writing with my regular font. So right now, I just finished all my writing sprints on Twitter and hosting those. I hosted 5 sprints, and so far I have 4,881 words. It is almost noon now, and that means that I am done, and I am giving, like, doing a handoff to my co-host, which is Brooke Passmore this month. She is doing writing sprints on her YouTube channel, and if you guys are watching this vlog now, you can always go ahead and watch the replay. If you want to do some sprints with her, you can always do the replay sprints. I'm done writing for a little bit. My brain is feeling burnt out. I do feel like I need to sit down and work on my outline before I can continue writing, because otherwise I'm just gonna write in circles and it's gonna be useless. I am getting to that point of slight panic where I don't know if this manuscript's gonna be ready in time for my alpha readers like I wanted it to be. I may have to push it out a month or two for my alpha readers, but we'll see. Even if that's the case, it should be good still for my publishing timeline. But I, of course, would like to finish stuff early. But this month and last month was a very busy month for me, just in terms of life. So I don't know why this month I sat down and was like, I'm going to write almost 50,000 words for my book. Because that's slightly unrealistic. I've already written 10,000 words in one day this month. It'd be crazy for me to write 10,000 words in one day for a second day. So basically what I'm saying is I'm closing the vlog now. I'm not necessarily done writing now, because I do want to run some errands, and then if I have time later, I'll do some more writing, but I probably won't feel like vlogging it. So this is me closing out the vlog, but this is also me saying the whole point of this challenge is not to write 10,000 words in a day. The whole point of this challenge is to see how many words you can write if you really set your mind to it. Sometimes you can write 10,000, sometimes you can write 15,000, sometimes you can only write 2,000. But my favorite part about the 10K writing challenge is that it teaches you to write faster. So if you want to do some fast drafting, you can do that. And it also teaches you that even if you only have an hour of time that you can write, you can definitely write. Because if you can write all day and then your brain is exhausted, just think the next time you go to sit to write and you're like, I only need to write for an hour, that's gonna seem like a piece of cake. Because right now, writing 10,000 words in one day is not a piece of cake, and it shouldn't be a piece of cake for anyone. It's hard work, and it's totally worth it when you finish. It's just really hard to get there. So yeah, I hope you guys all enjoyed this writing vlog. If you have any ideas for like future writing vlogs, let me know. If these are entertaining to you, let me know. Sometimes I just feel like I'm talking to a camera. It's not all that entertaining, but what do I know? Anyways, thank you all for watching. If you'd like to stay up to date with everything I'm up to, subscribe to my author newsletter, or if you'd like cool exclusive content, join me over on Patreon, because it's a really fun place to be. Thank you.